And apa yang you rasa nak share dekat dekat Siputan punya viewers malam ni?
About ni,
what is that wow factor? Wow factor, orang kata okay lepas ni I nak. Compared to other products, I tak boleh sebut nama produk tu. Compared to that other product, say I want to try Mentimeter for a change kan. Apa benda yang beza sangat dia ni as compared to others?
Okay, I like Mentimeter ni sebabnya bila kita dah explore banyak apa bila banyakkan kita guna yang simple-simple aje, kita buat quiz apa tanya soalan bagaimana tu, tapi banyak lagi benda dalam Mentimeter yang kita boleh explore. Today because of just a quick one, just I going start with introduction apakah itu Mentimeter, macam mana nak log in into Mentimeter. Kemudian kita akan look into apa yang ada dalam Mentimeter tu yang kita boleh explore. And then kita akan look into kita play lah, kita try it out. Sebab Mentimeter ni dia cara nak belajar dia kena kita kena try. Kita kena play with it first, explore that. Lepas tu baru kita tengok macam mana kita nak set up kan, how do I get the same result? Macam mana I nak gunakan tu? So I'll show one or two question type. Macam mana kita nak set up kan yang mana kita play tadi tu? Kita tunjuk macam mana kita set up kan those two tools tu. Contoh jadi bila lepas daripada sesi yang short sesi ni, at least you boleh balik lepas tu buka onkan Mentimeter, can try at least one or two yang kita sempat share pada hari ni.
So sekejap belum apa-apa dah ada soalan.
Ah ya ke, apa soalannya?
Soalan dia, Mentimeter ni boleh add dalam MS Teams ke?
Boleh ke MS Team ke? MS Team, I rasa boleh rasanya. Boleh ke Kelvin?
Boleh.
Ah boleh. Yang itu kena tanya pakar MS Team. Saya Zoom saja. I rasa boleh. Kalau you sebagai host, you boleh add dekat MS Team tu, dia ada option you boleh add on.
Dah ada extension you boleh add kan?
Asalkan ada dia punya web address.
Web address dia.
So I think that's that. Yang tu kena pasal cerita pasal MS Team, saya kena tolaklah soalan tu kepada pakar-pakar yang memang menggunakan Microsoft Team.
Dekat sini mana-mana you labelkan pakar you.
Takat ni saya cuma nampak Kelvin sahaja. Kelvin saja, sebab dia sentiasa membantu kita orang yang agak apa ilmu cetek dengan Microsoft ni.
Hey, kan sebenarnya yang paling paling pro kan adalah siapa tu? Gita.
Betul. Gita memang mengajar, tapi Gita busy, so you sentiasa sedia membantu kita.
Gita is a pro.
Tiap-tiap kali kena Lina, tengok Kelvin pun muka dia bijak.
Balas tak layan.
Lama tak usik dia kan. Hari ni dia live. Ni peluang. Okay, let's begin. Let us begin. So,
okay, alright. Let me start share. Along the process tu, kalau ada soalan sila tanya je. Sebabnya kalau tidak, I akan share apa yang I rasa I nak share saja. So bila ada soalan, tanya saja. Dan yang mana yang I boleh answer, I answer. Kalau yang mana yang tak boleh tu, nanti I explore, I akan jawab balik. Alright, let me just share my screen ya. Okay, can everybody see my screen yang ada Mentimeter ni?
Yes.
Okay, so let me just minimize that so that I can have full screen. Okay, so kalau Mentimeter ni, nak masukkan ke dalam Mentimeter ni, kita type in mentimeter.com. Yeah, so ini adalah kalau kita Google mentimeter.com ni, dia akan ada ni. So let me just tunjuk macam mana kita nak masuk ya. So seperti biasa, kita Google mentimeter.com, Google sahaja. Kemudian klik saja kat sini. Okay, so bila macam I dah ada login ID kan, so mine dia akan automatically dia akan masuk dekat I punya screen lah sebab I dah login. Tapi kalau yang belum tu, bila you masuk saja, dia akan request sama ada you want to sign in ataupun you ada, kalau you dah ada login ID, just terus login saja. So macam mine, because I dah login, so basically I already have. Bila masuk saja, you will have something like this. Now, bila kata nak login tu, you boleh create, sama ada create own password ataupun kita boleh login menggunakan Google account. So boleh saja masuk. Kadang-kadang kalau malas nak fikir, malas nak simpan password and whatnot, just login ataupun sign in menggunakan register menggunakan Google password ataupun ID ya. So bila kita masuk saja ke Mentimeter, kita akan sampai ke page ni. Okay, Mentimeter ni. So let me just walk you through apa yang ada kat sini. Daripada atas ni, yang atas ni upgrade ni adalah sebab saya sekarang I guna yang free version sahaja. Tapi kalau kita upgrade then you have to pay certain amount. Yang inilah upgrade ni. Kalau nak upgrade lebih, ada banyaklah feature lain yang boleh digunakan. So macam I dah banyak buat Mentimeter. So dekat sini ni adalah semua slide-slide ataupun soalan-soalan yang I pernah buat. So yang ini adalah my list. Okay. Then dekat sini kalau kata macam mana ni masa first time masuk Mentimeter, kata macam mana I nak buat, tak tahu macam mana rupa dia. So dia ada satu ni terpanggil inspiration. So kalau kita klik dekat inspiration ni, you akan ada few things. Dia ada sample-sample. You pilih lah mana yang you nak. Basically ada for as speaker, as business. There's a lot more. So I enjoy explore kat sini sebab macam-macam ada kat sini. So bila dia tulis dekat sini add to my presentation, maksudnya you boleh saja terus add to your presentation and terus guna. Contohnya, let me just show you a bit ya. Contohnya kalau I katalah I click this one. Okay, automatically you will go into your my presentation. You akan nampak benda tu dekat sini. You will have that. Dia akan ada kat sini example. Okay, so lepas tu you bolehlah nak amend macam mana ke, you can do that as well. Yeah. So this is from the inspiration. So once you dah masuk dalam Mentimeter, this is something you nak explore. Macam-macam ada dekat situ. Kalau rasa macam I do not know what to do, then you can look into that. So kalau kata kita gunakan daripada inspiration directly, kita tak nak create our own, then we can just click dekat sini. I'm just going to show this example dahulu ya. Okay, automatically dia akan ada macam gini. So dah siap-siap dah. So kalau kata nak guna terus, guna je terus. Kalau rasa-rasa nak modify, kita modify. So yang ini terus saja dah ada dah. So kalau kata sesuai untuk program you, katakanlah you buat program leadership program lah contohnya, then you can also do that. Ataupun you buat macam maybe you run a session untuk your entrepreneur ke ataupun your business owner ke, then you also can use this one and post it up. I'll share with you macam mana kita nak post nanti ya. Okay, so that's one. So I'm going to go back to home. Alright, go back to home. Okay, so sekarang ni sebab tadi ada guna dan you kan nampak dekat sini. So macam mana nak baca dekat sini ni? Ya, di sini ni maksudnya ini adalah title of your presentation tadi. And then kat sini dia tulis ada dua slide. So kalau kata contohnya kita dah pernah guna, I nak reuse balik benda tu. Contohnya yang ini I buat for capability and training metrics. I pakai satu slide saja. Yang ini voices ni maksudnya dah ada response. So sekiranya I nak reuse yang ini, then I kena make sure that download dulu dia punya response ataupun I duplicate. Okay, yang tu later on kita akan tunjuk. Okay, so apa kata kita buat satu presentation lepas tu kita try it out. Boleh? Okay, so untuk kita create a presentation, kita start dulu dengan new presentation. Alright, so hari ni kita buat sebab semua orang baru dinner kan. So apa kata kita kita nak tanya semua apa dia makan hari ni. So let's say kita start with dinner. Contohlah title dia lah dinner. So create presentation. Okay, so automatically lepas kita masuk dekat situ, you akan nampak all this option. Ini pilihan-pilihan yang ada macam mana you nak buat. So kita nak tengok macam mana rupa dia. So kalau multiple, kalau kita hover dia, kita lalu je kat sini kita punya mouse tu, kita akan nampak oh ini kalau kata multiple choice macam ni rupa dia. Kalau kata word cloud macam ni lah outcome dia nanti. Open-ended, bila kita dapat respon then it will come like this. Ada yang gunakan skill, ranking, Q&A. So banyak ada. So macam-macam ada. Daripada yang ini yang paling simple dan kepada yang agak advanced question here. So let's start with something simple. Apa kata kita, sebab I nak tahu apa you nak makan tadi. So kita go into, kita nak choose word cloud. Okay. Right, daripada word cloud ni, kita try. Okay, I dah banyak benda ni. So I akan choose. Alright, so kat sini I kata alright, saya bagi you peluang lah sebab kadang-kadang kita kan Malaysian. Kalau kita Malaysian mana ada makan satu benda je untuk dinner. Mestilah makan kadang nasi, kalau nasi mesti ada lauk tiga jenis kan. So kita ada macam-macam. Saya bagi you peluang lah tiga entries per participant. So how do you get all of you to start responding? You just click dekat sini. Present. Alright. So now, what you need to do untuk participant. So what I like all of you to go adalah dekat sini. Mentimeter.com and this is dia punya code dia.
Jom, sama-sama masuk. Jom, jom.
Sila masuk, sila masuk, sila masuk.
7606.
Yep. So, kita masuk menti.com. Use the code 8487606. So, let's see if I can. Okay, you boleh pakai QR code as well. Okay, so go to mentimeter.com, enter this code ataupun you just scan the QR code yang I letak dekat screen sekarang. Okay, so ada ada respon. Okay, makan makanan apa? Sky juice. Sky juice. Allah ni diet ke ni?
Ah, sky juice tu makanan ke?
Itulah itulah terfikir tu, sky juice. Okay, dia mungkin ada different type of sky of makanan kot sky juice ni. Okay. Makan angin. Okay. Alright, ini mesti budget tahap kritikal punya ni sebab dia makan angin dan juga sky juice sahaja. Okay, ada nasi lemak. Oh boy. Half boiled egg, I see. And then kima, amboi sedapnya. Kima, ini Mak Saleh pizza. Okay, ini pure Malaysia ni. Mesti makan mihu goreng. So kita tengok. Alright, siapa lagi respon? Okay, kita ada sekarang ni yang respon adalah 9 orang. Kat bawah ni, kalau you nampak adalah berapa orang yang dah respon kat kita. Okay, from this. Okay, kat bawah ni. So kita nampak ada 11, you know, yang respon. Okay, keep on coming. Apa lagi? Okay, so ada sebuah steam fish, ayam goreng. Okay, so bila kita tengok yang ni, macam mana kita nak tahu apa yang paling banyak sekali? So size font dia ni akan besar size tu, besar font tu maksudnya itu yang paling banyak respon dia. So seperti biasa kita mention apa lagi yang paling banyak? Rice. Okay, so yang mana yang bukan mak salad, oh sebab dia ada rice, ada nasi, so tak masuk kategori lah. So nasi dengan rice, okay. So ada, oh ada yang agak simple, viet roll, canggih. Okay, so this is how it looks like. Ya, yeah, kalau kata untuk that one here. Ada lagi nak respon ke? Cukup ke? Okay, so ada lagi ke? Ada lagi nak respon ke? Nak tunggu sekejap ke? Nak bagi orang lain respon. Tapi ini je kan yang respon kan?
Ya.
Yeah. Okay, so so kita ada, okay, rice. Semua orang makan nasi. Amboi, kata Malaysia ni kan, mesti nak makan nasi. So inilah yang paling banyak, paling ramai yang makan, apa inilah apa yang semua orang makan dinner hari ni, ramai yang makan rice. Okay, so, ada singgang, mak ai. Sup ABC. Okay, yang angin dengan sky juice ni, I rasa memang sedih sikit lah tu. Alright. Okay, so this is one of the way kalau macam kita nak buat simple. Contohnya, I suka pakai Mentimeter sebabnya benda ni anonymous. Jadi, kalau kita buat dalam meeting lah contohnya, kita nak dapat respon sesuatu yang kita nak panggil macam blind voting lah contohnya ya. So, kalau kata kita minta orang angkat tangan ke apa ke, people will feel reluctant. Takut nanti mungkin dalam meeting tu ada bosses, ada apa kan, ada bos-bos kita. Takut nanti bila kita jawab sesuatu, nanti lepas meeting saja dia panggil, dia kata kenapa you jawab macam itu. Jadi, bila kita pakai Mentimeter untuk buat macam quiz macam gini, kita tanya dia whatever question lah kita tanya kan. So bila orang respon, nobody can pinpoint siapa yang jawab apa. Tapi kita still dapat respon. So that's why kenapa I suka pakai Mentimeter, sebab dia adalah, kita panggil undi itu rahsia, this is the one. Kan? So jadi mudah sebabnya masa I buat kelas pun, contohnya kita ada kelas, lepas tu macam kita buat virtual sekarang ni, and then kadang-kadang ada company tu dia letak semua orang dalam satu bilik. Jadi ada bos lah, ada semua dalam tu. Jadi bila nak respon, nak unmute mungkin bising. Jadi apa yang kita gunakan, dia tak ada orang nak respon dalam masa meeting tu. Masa dalam training tu. So I cepat-cepat buat, sebab kan kalau perasan tadi kan sekejap saja I set upkan the quiz tadi ni, launch. So dalam masa meeting tu terus saja I, masa dia orang break, I bagi break dalam maybe 10 minutes, I terus buatkan this one, and then bila they come back, I launchkan this poll ataupun this quiz. So mudah I nak dapatkan respon, and from there I boleh start to debrief the people. Jadi I gunakan, kadang-kadang I gunakan masa nak start icebreaker. Ini macam inilah icebreaker. What do you have for dinner? Kalau kata pagi, tanyalah what's your breakfast ke? What do you want to learn now? So those are the things. Okay, ada soalan takat ni?
Belum lagi. Tapi kalau kita kat sini, tadi ada perasan kan, dia ada pricing. Tadi nampak ada pricing. Is free or paid?
Kalau yang I guna sekarang ni is still free. Kalau yang I guna sekarang ni adalah free. So free dia pun banyak juga option dia. So tak habis pun kita boleh gunakan. Cuma kalau kata kita nak guna macam kalau tengok Mentimeter ni, yang mana yang ada lambang macam star ni, yang ini adalah apa features yang ada dalam upgrade version, pro version dia.
Okay. Ada beza tak? Apa banyak beza di antara free dengan paid?
Takkan ni sebab I tak upgrade, so tak sure sangat apa lagi yang bezanya antara apa yang paid dengan yang apa yang berbayar dengan yang free. Sebab I rasa kalau kata takat kita nak guna untuk buat quizzes ni, dia punya free version pun memadai, is enough untuk you buat poll, untuk you buat analysis. Kalau yang upgrade version tu, you boleh change satu yang paling ketara lah. Kalau kata free version ni, you cuma boleh buat setiap code ni dua slide sahaja. You tak boleh buat banyak slide. Jadi kalau katalah you run katalah one whole day punya session ke, so you mesti, kalau you nak buat banyak-banyak, maksudnya you kena ada okay, dua slide untuk ni, lepas tu I buka lagi another link untuk sesi yang berbeza. Itu yang paling ketara. So kalau kata you berbayar, so you ada unlimited. Jadi kan you boleh even buat your presentation, you tak payah pakai dekat PowerPoint, you terus boleh buat dekat dalam Mentimeter, everything inside here.
Betul, betul. Agree.
Kan? So itu yang paling beza. Lepas tu yang salah satu yang paling yang beza dia lagi tu kalau kata ya apa yang membayar punya tu you can customize dia punya theme tu sikit. Maksudnya you boleh letak you punya logo ke, you boleh letak. So ada banyak apa flexibility on how you design your slide lah. Macam kalau kata free ni nama pun free kan. So dia tak adalah boleh customize. So kalau perasan dekat sini nampak ya yang ada customize ni yang ini there's a lot more kalau kata you pun bayar.
Tapi first kan kita kena skill kan. Tool is a tool but skill untuk maneuver dia supaya kan tujuan dia betul dah untuk kita boleh buat kita punya online meeting ke online training more engaging kan. So I think wah ni memang best ni nak try ni. Ni kita ada soalan ni. Okay. Nombor satu daripada Al-Malik Syuib. Dia kata so basically soalan-soalan ni available sampai bila-bila kan?
Terus ada yes. Yes. So macam kalau perasan I have a lot of things that are a lot of others that I have done. Kalau if you look into that my presentation too, I have all those questions or all those things I have created before. So I can even reuse that. Tapi cuma I have to be mindful not to override the result. Kalau let's say I decided I don't need the result anymore, then should be okay. Tapi perasan tak dekat tepi ni ada download result kat tepi ni.
Yeah.
Yes. So macam kalau perasan, I have a lot of things that are a lot.
Hello.
Hello.
Kenapa tu?
Sudah terputus.
Tak apa.
Okay. So kalau macam contohnya macam ni kan, kalau you perasan dekat my screen ni nampak tak dekat sini tu download result. So kalau let's say macam tadi kan kita dah jawab sesemua dah. So I boleh je download result ni. Selepas tu, so once ada download result, I can reuse this, I can reset the result. So so basically I dah capture this one dalam somewhere dalam dia akan go into, let's say kita buat, let's say kita try. Kita download result ni. Okay, dia akan go into a PDF format.
Right.
Alright. So jadi kan you dah capture, lepas tu you boleh kalau you nak upgrade to Excel ke terpulang lah. Tapi kalau macam so that's why kalau kata you akan Mentimeter ni is very clear, dia very transparent. Dia akan cerita dengan you kalau upgrade apa yang you kena buat untuk you upgrade. So tak ada hidden agenda punya tu. So kalau nak export to Excel, you nak analyze and you kena upgrade lah. Then dia ada dia punya, dia akan break it down into detail. Tapi kalau tak, enough sajalah you ada this one. Okay, download dinner. Then you nak kat mana you nak simpannya. So kalau kata I nak download dinner, so I download je lah. So now I dah ada that result tu which I boleh add on ataupun I boleh send to my client contohnya. Kan? So this is like the PDF format already. Okay, so now it's up to me. Kalau kata I tak mau pakai, then I can, so I already capture, so I simpan. So I nak kalau kata macam client kata, eh boleh tak you bagi dekat I that survey yang kita buat hari tu tu. So you download and then you bagi dia dalam PDF format. Okay, the beauty of it, they will never know who answer what. So it is safe for you to actually share this result because they will never be able to say okay siapa yang jawab benda ni. They will not. Tapi kalau kata dalam group tu cuma ada 3 orang sahaja, Al-Faham sahajalah. Kan? Kalau kata the boss, me dengan dia je. So itu tak dapatlah nak tolongnya bab tu kan. But then again, there's a reason why a lot apa bila kata nak buat simple-simple macam gini, a quick response, this is the best tool yang I can think of. Of course kita ada yang tools lain macam apa market survey ke apa ke, bit more complicated. Tapi kalau just quick for quick response for a simple assessment, a simple apa you nak gauge what is their feeling at that moment, what is their response. So this is the best that one I feel lah.
Okay, so kalau tiga orang tadi kan? Tiga orang bos, orang kanan bos, staff. Confirm dekat ini confirm bukan orang kanan aku.
So yang itu tak dapatlah nak kata apa kan.
Tapi tadi sebenarnya dia macam sixth sense kepada the next question lepas pada Malik tau. G tanya tadi, G tanya kan, dia kata dia tak boleh print or in different format of example Excel. Dah jawab dah tadi.
Okay.
Jawab sekali. Betul, Diana Hao tanya, preversion boleh buat berapa presentation? Dua kan tadi?
Dua. Kalau satu, setiap link, setiap code, cuma you allow to do two sahaja. Two slide sahaja. So,
might mean two different questions lah.
Two different question. So, let me just show you, I balik kepada yang I punya apa example tadi ni ya. So, I'm go back to my presentation. Okay. Lepas tu, now katakanlah yang dinner tadi ni kita nak add on. Okay, kita nak add on another question lah. Katakanlah. Right, kita ambil balik yang dinner ni. Sebab bila, even though kita ada dua soalan, kita still boleh control bila kita post tu, also ni first, bila kita buka, the whatever yang kita show dekat slide tu, that's the only one yang dia orang boleh access. The people can, you only can see one slide, even though you ada two slide. And the next slide tu is when the facilitator akan move that slide ataupun show the second slide, then only the participant will be able to vote. Yeah. So kalau kata this one, so every time you akan buat dua slide saja. Let me just show you what happen ya. Kalau let's say kita decided nak add a third slide. Okay, so I ada this one, the second slide. So same thing, dia tanya, okay, you nak letak apa sekarang ni? Sebab tapi title still the same ya, because of you are still in the same, we call that file lah kita consider. Okay, lepas tu kita kata, alright, I nak different question. So second ni I nak letak macam mana? Oh, I nak apa, buat
kenyang, different type lah. Kenyang ke tidak?
Kita nak pakai, let's say, kita nak pakai something different lah, multiple choice. Okay, kita pakai multiple choice. Okay, multiple choice. Lepas tu, I kata, I nak buat something different lah, nak buat fun sikit. You perasan tak dekat tepi ni, dia ada macam gambar image? Okay, so katakanlah, tadi ada tanya you pasal makanan. So, I kata, I still lah nak team yang sama juga, I nak tanya you, okay, favorite. Favorite Malaysian food. Makanan lagi kan? Kita kan Malaysian. Alright. So sekarang ni I kata okey lah, I bagi option pertama. Kita kata nasi lemak. Okay, nasi lemak. Alright. So sekarang ni kenalah ada gambar nasi lemak, betul tak? Okay, so now I ada option sama ada I upload daripada file yang I sedia ada ataupun I boleh search dalam internet. Tapi nak cari nasi lemak dalam internet tak jumpa lah you. Dia tak kenal. Dia tak kenal dalam internet. So, apa yang you boleh buat, kalau katalah you rasa okay, you punya image tu might be something a bit complicated. You search dulu siap-siap and then you save. And then let's see, let me see. Okay, I dah ada kat dalam my file dah, nasi lemak ni. Okay, so what I do now, I just drop nasi lemak ni, I just drop dekat dalam ni. Ta-da! Okay, so now I save. Tada, nasi lemak. Okay, so second one. Kita punya favourite. Apa ya, kalau nasi lemak, apa lagi kita punya favourite? Roti canai perhaps?
Kari mi.
Kari mi breakfast.
Yelah, I patut letak favourite breakfast kan? Malaysian breakfast kan? Okay, roti canai. So kita pun cari juga, okay, roti canai. Tengok boleh tak kita jumpa dalam kita punya apa image library contohnya. Carilah roti canai. Ada tak?
Kalau pancake
Pancake, oh, dia tak kenal lah. Dia tak kenal, tak apalah. I pun upload. So, I pun cari. I pun dah jumpa dah nasi lemak apa roti canai. Yum-yum. Okay, same thing, you save. kan? So then option nombor tiga, I kata okay lah, maybe I buat heavy sikit lah, kuih tiaw goreng, yang ni favourite I. So I letak suka hati, I letak. Okay. Okay. So again, I dah tahu dah memang susah nak cari, so I decided to just download dah siap-siap tadi, and then I just transfer and drop inside here. Tada! Ooh, sedapnya kuih goreng. Cik baiklah, sekarang ni payah nak cari makan malam-malam. Alright, so now I dah ada semua-semua ni, apa lagi? Kita pun seperti biasa, once you dah, bila you set it up, automatically dia akan ada semua ni. So I kata alright lah, I nak add lagi slide. So bila you add another slide, automatically dia akan kata, okay, you have reached the maximum number of question for Mentimeter free. Sila upgrade. Tengoklah pricing dia. Okay, faham-fahamlah maksudnya tu. Yeah. So jadi faham-fahamlah sebabnya anda kan apa, maksudnya kita jangan over-over minta lebih-lebih, dah bagi free jangan over-over. So cancel lah sahaja kan part tu. Jadi maintain lah dua ni. So setiap kali you wanted, if let's say that you wanted to run several sesi kan. So my suggestion that is you space it out. Katakanlah before lunch pula masa start the classes. Start the class, you buat icebreaker, you pakai satu link. And then lepas tu mungkin after lunch, katakanlah kelas you ada dua sesi ataupun morning and afternoon. After lunch, you nak buat as an icebreaker energizer. Then you can create another one with a different kind of link. So senang juga nak manage sebenarnya bila you ada different link macam itu. Okay.
Ni ada soalan ni. Banyaklah untuk turut lah. I say glamour lah you ni. Okay, ni G Muhammad tanya, yang free version how many person boleh respond?
I do not know what's the maximum. I tak pernah try sampai the maximum, tapi boleh saja try. Tak salah I think ada juga orang yang bertanya. Ada somebody pernah post hari tu, dia kata ikut up to 2000, but I'm not sure whether that is free ataupun is paid version. That one I don't have the answer. No, kat mana I serve dekat Mentimeter pun I tak nampak benda tu. Maybe anyone else can answer for me on that part.
Maybe Kelvin ke?
Kelvin eh.
Okay, dalam website, if you look at the website, it actually says unlimited. Sejauh mana unlimited saya
tahu. Itulah. Dia ada question mark sikit lah.
Unlimited audience.
Ramai gila ni. Ramai sangat pun tak respon. Sampai berjuta.
Itu sebabnya I think that's why Mentimeter kalau kata as well, free tools it help. Okay, slide boleh dua saja, tapi kalau macam kalau let's say you nak buat quizzes tu, kalau kata banyak macam more than I don't know lah, maybe somebody can try lah and then see tak kat mana dia kata okay sudah. Then you can have, tapi it is kalau kata you are running in a bigger crowd, I like Mentimeter because you just lepak saja tunggu orang respon saja. And then kalau you perasan kalau work club tu, yang mana yang similar respon dia terus dia group kan. Jadi tak adalah bersepah dekat dalam situ. Okay. But ada soalan lain tak? Apa?
Ada. Confirm ada. You tak banyak ada soalan. Confirm ada soalan untuk you.
Okay.
Confirm.
Saya.
Apa tu?
Cuba masukkan satu soalan quiz. Tengok boleh tak?
Masukkan kat sini ke apa?
Tak, you pergi ke add slide. You cuba masukkan satu soalan quiz. Tengok boleh tak?
Boleh. Nampak situ dia kata you have reached your maximum number. Kan.
Okay, ni ada soalan daripada Bina ni. Bina kata, berapa lama voting code tu available? Time frame ada ke? Ataupun dia memang sampai kita tutup account?
Okay, voting ke? Maksudnya yeah. Bila kita ni, alright. So dia, kita boleh close the voting. So maksudnya katakanlah kita ni, let me just show you kat mana ya. Okay, so apa kata kita, yang ini sebenarnya boleh buat sampai 5 ya, option ni. Tapi I tak kuasa lah nak sampai 5 ke kan. Nanti kan I pula lapar. So let's say kita present at the moment. Kita present benda ni. So you perasan I still pakai the same code ya. So kalau tadi you dah log in into the same code, you actually boleh go to the next slide and you can see that dekat situ dia akan mention you have another slide, another quiz to do it. Okay, dekat bawah ni kalau perasan dekat bawah ni dia akan ada satu tu, alamak tak nampak dah pula ni. Dia ada yang dekat bawah ni, dia ada where you can, they can tell, let's say whether ada countdown. You ada this one whether voting, voting open ataupun close. So you can actually close the voting kalau you tak nak anybody continue to vote anymore. Okay, so you boleh kat situ. So you boleh control at that particular that portion dekat bawah ni, help you to manage that. Okay, so boleh respon dah. Sambil-sambil kita sembang ni, silalah respon makanan-makanan yang anda minat.
Yes, dah masuk ni. Ni. Ada fax ni yang Sifu Malik, dia tolong cek untuk kita ni. Dia kata as for Mentimeter, dia kata unlimited audience size means that you can present your Mentimeter presentation in front of an audience of any size and they can use a smartphone to interact. Please note that quizzes are limited to up to 500 users.
Okay. So maksudnya ada limit lah.
Ada limit lah.
Okay lah. I mean 500 user tu pun okay lah tu. Kita pergi kelas berapa orang? Kelas I kalau dapat 12, kalau online ni dapat kira 12 orang tu kira terror dah lah.
Kelas terkayangan, ramai sangat.
Okay, so sama je semua nasi lemak di sana kuih goreng. Nampak sangatlah kita Malaysia ni memang apa, makan yang makanan yang kaya dengan kalori.
Memang saiz lah masing-masing kita kalau keluar tu.
kan, so basically yang respon berapa, ada 6 responses. Okay. Alright, so this is how it looks like. So kat sini, I mean you boleh up to your creativity lah, nak letak gambar macam mana, you know. So at least it adds some flavor, it adds some interesting things. At least kalau kita nak tanya pun, dia tak payah banyak explain. Sebab ni kita kata favorite mission pun ada 3 ni, nasi lemak. Oh, rupa nasi lemak macam gini, rupa canai, nak kerja goreng. So one thing, because kita ada visual, then ada grafik, jadi everybody yang dekat wherever you are when you run this, everybody have the same understanding what are you referring at. You know, kalau roti canai, kan ada yang kata roti prata lah, pakai lah. Okay, ini rupa dia roti canainya. Okay, nasi lemak macam tu rupa dia. Ada telur, ada sambal, ada bagainya. Ini version dia. Okay, so bukannya ais krim nasi lemak ke apa ke, tak ada. Okay. Alright. So then bila kata kita then kita up to us lah how long kita decided to do that. Kalau kata let's say you wanted to have timing ya. Contohnya you kata okay I nak ada crowd ni, I nak let's say maybe you wanted to control the response. So you boleh start to, kat bawah ni ada countdown. So you boleh decide how long you wanted to have that countdown. Okay, to the voting close. You can do that as well. Alright, so then kalau kata ni I just close lah sebabnya I dah tak ada buat countdown kan. So that's how it works into that. Okay, alright. So now kalau let's say I kata okay lah, dah habis dah semua dah voting dah. Alright, so this is the result. Again, kalau kita nak download, we can download the result. Kalau tak ada, then we just close. Kita exit saja kat sini. Then we just go back to where we wanted to do lah. Again, it come up something like this. So it's quite easy because every time you close, dia akan tanya you nak use lagi tak. Kalau you nak use, you boleh download the result. Kalau you tak nak, you can reset the result. Okay, reset maksudnya I can reuse the same one as well. Okay, it tak payahlah macam you nak create banyak-banyak. So macam I pun ada setengah tu I dah create untuk I practice. Lepas tu I can reset. I play around, I masuk and then lepas tu I practice, I log in on my own different device. Just nak tengok macam mana respond. And then lepas tu when I wanted to use in my class, I just reset the result and I can still use the same one. So I tak payah create banyak-banyak. So I still can do that the same thing. Okay. Awesome. So kalau kata you run the same topic, contohnya katakanlah you run a session on effective leadership. So you ada three session lah contohnya. In the same company, three session. So takkanlah every time you nak buat kelas, you nak create another Mentimeter. So what you do is you download yang result yang ini, save dah, and then reset the result, you can use the same one as well. Jadi you cuma kerja keras the first session sahaja. You set up kan the whole thing. And then you can still reuse benda tu. So if let's say now, and then for you can also create several that you think you might want to use. Jadi kalau kata tiba-tiba dalam kelas tu tak ada orang menjawab, tak ada orang jawab, semua macam tak semangat aja, then you look through whatever that you have, you can launch that immediately. So kalau you perasan, as I shared just now, is simple untuk you set up kan the Mentimeter, and so fast for you to present, to launch that, and it's very easy for people to respond as well. Dia tak ada complicated sangat. Ada soalan ke?
Eh, confirm ada. Ni G tanya ni, dia rasa dia dah jadi fan you buat Mentimeter ni. Can we, siapa yang dah respond or semua anonymous? For administrator view, example for the training purposes, we need to identify siapa packs yang dah respond.
Dia tak ada sebab dia memang designed to be anonymous. Dia memang designed to be anonymous. The reason kenapa, that's why that I like this one here, because it take away the part where oh nanti ada orang akan check benda-benda ni. So it take away that fear. Jadi people will respond with sincerity. You know, even though you download macam mana pun, you will not be able to pinpoint siapa yang respond macam ni. No, it will not.
But having said that, I think kan kita boleh nampak the number of people yang dah respond.
Betul.
Kalau kita tahu dah kita memang ada 20 orang, so we should have 20.
Betul. Tapi remember that because I allow, let's say, kalau kata I allow only one respond, one participant, then you automatically ada 20 respond sahajalah. So katakanlah I allow kata 3 respond per participant. So you will have more responses that comes in. It might not equate the number of participant that you have.
I see.
Jadi because I think from the people that I use for me, I guna pun I see the changes, the changes in the training program, the dynamic. Because macam masa mula-mula kita buat kelas tu, macam semua orang bila tanya je, okay lah kita pakai Zoom kan, okay respond on the chat. Semua macam fikir macam mana susun ayat ni. Right, so then and then lepas tu fikir, alamak nanti kalau sudah dalam chat tu semua orang boleh baca, so that's gonna be great. You know, people are very uncomfortable to share. So I automatically lepas tu I kata okay cannot lah, tak jadi macam ni sebab respon payah sangat. So I switch to Mentimeter. Dah ada yang standby semua ni. So just quickly launch. Then lepas tu kita start to have all the responses. From there, then we can have a good discussion. We can also, we know where they are, so kita can stress on certain topic after that. So it's help us to guide that as well. So dalam satu kelas tu, I think masa kita run 2 hari, I think 4 session lah, sebab 2 days worth of program kan. So kita memang banyak pakai Mentimeter je. Macam-macam style kita guna. Kita buat stakeholder analysis pun pakai Mentimeter. Kita nak dapatkan ranking on certain thing pun kita pakai Mentimeter. So memang the reason kenapa I maintain satu tu, sebab satu I tak kita dah start using it, they are familiar with it. But then the quizzes are different. So that's kita perbagaikan that part tu. Tak adalah work cloud di semendang.
Kreatif lah kan, kena kreatif. Tool tu memang
kena kreatif.
Kreatif lah kan. Sangat penting.
Betul, betul. Okay. So itu basically what the Mentimeter is all about. So is there are a lot more yang yang I akan cover lah. Let's say, kalau kata nak go through everything tu kena ada masa nak go through. Sebab macam ni kita share, but you have to try on your own. But if you have it's not easy for selalu kita attend, okay macam boleh, tapi lepas tu bila buat macam mana ni kan. So there's a lot more that we can explore, and usually kalau kata ada masa we can get people to test it out, to play it out, and then maybe try it out with a participant, lepas tu debrief that as well. So that's I think kalau kata you talking about a trainer ataupun if you are hosting this Mentimeter, you nak gunakan tu, you need to know how to use it as well, for what purpose. Right, so lepas you dapat result tu, macam mana kita nak debrief benda tu. So those are the some of the skill yang the train that where kita combine that make it more engaging is when we use the tools to help us facilitate the discussion.
Ni kita nak tengok ni yang dalam dalam Zoom kita ni ramai ni kan. Is there any questions? Siapa-siapa tadi nak tanya soalan tadi? Ada macam ada Azizul tadi nak tanya soalan kan. Mana Azizul? Azizul. Mana dia?
Yes.
Nak tanya soalan apa tadi?
Belum ada soalan.
Belum ada soalan. Okey. saya berterima kasih sebab tak ada soalan. Okey.
Jangan. Dia offer. Dia keluar waktu besok.
Okey. So basically itu sahaja yang I dapat share pada malam ni. There's a lot more that we can share dalam Mentimeter ni lah kan. So basically once we dah create, so what I think what's the takeaway from Mentimeter, satu, it is, I consider is a safe survey tools. Sebabnya is anonymous. Jadi bila kita talk to, bila kita launch this, kita create this dalam kita punya kelas, even though kat dalam tu ada bosses lah, ada yang so it, we cut cross the whole thing because of kita, one, we will not be able to pinpoint, even though kalau dia minta dengan kita pun, kita kata I can give you the sample on that, you know, the end result, but I will not be able to know who answer what. So that's cut the whole thing of the part, I takut nak respond. So I like that. So one of the beauty about Mentimeter because of is anonymous and people feel more comfortable to respond to it.
Soalan. Tadi saya tengok ada dua slide tadi kan. Okay, so kita dah pergi the second slide. So boleh tak kita back to the first slide and allow responses lagi?
Boleh, kalau kata let's say kita belum close lagi the voting tu, so you still can go back to the first slide.
Okay.
Tapi selalunya kita tak buat lah macam itu, sebabnya the first, so kita have to know why kita use this survey ni. So kalau yang first slide tu kita guna untuk apa? Kita dah debrief benda tu. Kalau kata kita dah first slide kan, jadi kita move to the second slide tu is supposed to be a different topic altogether dah. Kita have to memang kena plan betul-betul. Okay, either dua slide I boleh pakai ni. Okay, first slide ni I nak guna masa bila. Then second slide, then what I do, why do I create this kind of question? Apa yang nak guna result ni untuk apa? So habis dah first slide tu. Then when you go to the second slide tu, then you can start to look something on different thing lah. So I tak pernah lah patah balik on that. So on the first slide tu, because mine, I'm very clear, kita clear kenapa kita nak guna the first one tu. Okay. Memang boleh kita go back to, but you just have to be, you need to know why kita nak go back to that part lah.
Okay, walaupun kita guna countdown tu?
Boleh, sebabnya you boleh open balik that countdown tu. So you can close, lepas tu you can open balik the voting.
Nah, sebab kita takut kadang dalam kelas, some of the participant mungkin tertinggal. Cikgu patah balik, cikgu patah balik, patah balik cikgu nak tengok soalan, nak contoh itulah.
Selalunya bila masa, sebab tu selalunya what I've done, I space out. Maksudnya yang pertama, soalan pertama tu, yang slide tu, okay kita cerita pasal topik ni, kita cerita pasal topik ni. Lepas tu okay kita dah habis, alright. I jarang guna countdown. Jarang guna countdown, so I bagi them time. Okay, kita bagi you 5 minit untuk respond. Okay, respond. Lepas tu kita tunjuk result dan kita brief on that. Lepas tu sekiranya yang the second slide tu pun related dengan topik yang you nak cerita dengan dia orang tu, and then only you launch the second slide. Tapi kalau tak, you lepak aje, and then you launch it later, maybe after you come to that topic ke, then you can launch that as well. So plan it out lah, plan it out macam mana nanti nak guna.
Okay, alright.
Ini ada soalan daripada Al-Malik lagi ni.
Yeah.
Kalau dah close voting, boleh tak open balik atau kena klik baru?
Boleh je open balik.
Balik
okay, kan? Let's say kita contohnya gunakan balik di sebabnya yang dinner ni kan. Yang tadi kita pakai pasal, sebab kan tak sempat nak jawab makan dinner apa tadi. So I katalah I masuk balik kepada that part here. So now dia dah ada respon ni. Dah ada respon sekarang ni because dah ada ni kan. So I decided okay tak apa, I nak present balik. I nak launch balik here. See? And then Okay, try cuba masuk balik dalam ni. See whether you can respond to it or not.
Try masuk balik.
Kalau kata masuk balik. Tapi masalahnya, here is the thing, ya. Yeah. One thing about Mentimeter, kalau you masuk balik dalam guna same devices, dia dah kata you dah jawab tadi dah. So kalau you nak ni, you kena masuk. Maksudnya, if you boleh open, tapi for other people yang maybe belum lagi log in. So kalau you dah log in your devices, the same device, you tak boleh.
Bagus sama tu kan?
Sebab dia kata dah, sudah, you dah jawab tadi dah. Dia tak ada cakap macam tu lah kan? But konsep dia macam itulah. So kalau kata let's say you had another device. Tadi you masuk melalui handphone, so now you nak masuk melalui computer. Yes, you can. You can. Tapi you tak boleh respond to the same question or the same code. You tak boleh guna the same one. If kalau kata you masuk dalam the same using the same devices. I tried to cheat tapi tak boleh. Okay, so you can see you can have people that you responded as well. So as
saya
long as
boleh respond, ini, boleh respond. Saya boleh respond boleh kan? Lagi.
Sebab I tak close the voting. So okay. The moment katakanlah I click sini, I click katakan I close voting close, you will not be able to do that. You tak boleh masuk dah already.
Okay. Cuma saya guna the same device. Saya guna handphone yang sama. Okay. Cuma saya guna browser yang berbeza.
So cheating sikitlah.
So saya guna Google Chrome.
Okay.
Dalamnya handphone. Dan I guna Opera pula.
Dia tak kawan lah. So dia tak ada link lah. Okay, maybe boleh. Ya. Yeah? Saya pakai Chrome saja, tak kenal Opera bagainya. Okay, so dekat sini ni you can contohnya dekat bawah ni banyak juga dia punya tools dia, ya. So katakanlah macam tadi kalau perasan so sekarang I dah close the voting. So even though anybody, semua orang dah tengok sekarang ni FB live, semua orang ada code ni. So now you tak nak lagi ada orang respond, so you just close the voting. So nothing can comes in after that dah. Okay, so selagi you belum close the voting, people can come in and vote for that. Yeah. So kalau example katakanlah tengah-tengah tu people kata I tak tahulah macam mana nak vote, then dekat tepi ni dia ada voting instruction as well. Okay, dia akan allow you to do that. Kalau kata you malas nak type, you ada QR code as well, you can do that. Right? So that's why it's very simple. It's a very easy to use for this Mentimeter. So kalau I nak close, you just pick up bawah ni kan, then you just close sahaja. You see, and then you will go back to this part here. Dia akan tanya sekarang ni you nak download ke tak mau download. Kalau tak mau, tak apa. Up to you. Okay. Then you want to go back to your ni, this one you can go back to your home. So so that part tu I dah close the voting, is no longer able to vote. Yeah. So this is how you manage. Katakanlah you nak guna Mentimeter, you nak post it dekat Facebook. Contohnya nak dapat respon banyak kan. So you open the voting, be mindful berapa lama you nak buka that voting tu. Right? So dia ada boleh copy the link tu and put inside the Facebook, then people can log in and vote. Whatever that you wanted them to vote lah. Lepas tu then you bagi your time frame, lepas tu you close the voting, you dapat result tu, you can just download and then post it on the Facebook. Okay, this is the result of what the question that we ask, macam dia look very professional.
Betul lah. Okay, last question.
Sure, boleh.
Pukul 10, biasalah sibuk time ni kan.
Yeah. Okay.
Apart from Mentimeter, ada tak tool yang boleh kata similar yang kita boleh guna dalam kita punya training ke meeting so that we look, you know, engaging, tapi kita ada different options rather than Mentimeter?
I tak explore lagi yang lain-lain, tapi ada juga yang tools yang berbeza. Macam let's say ada yang pakai Kahoot, ada yang pakai quizzes. You know, because kalau talking about quiz per se lah, okay, ada leaderboard bagai-bagai, you can pakai quizzes, Kahoot, so those are the things. So each tool ada dia punya differences je. Cumanya kalau kata nak simple tu, I just nak simple tu saja yang tak payah pening-pening nak set up, Mentimeter is the best. You tak payah pening-pening nak create, you dah ada tu. And then kalau kata yang lain-lain tu, mungkin you kena masuk, you kena sedap dan tengok. Yang ini katakanlah at you are in a meeting sekarang ni, you kata tak dapat respon. So I just want to get some respond. So then katakanlah dia kita break untuk tea break dah sekejap 10 minutes, you boleh automatically set. Tadi I buat pun tak sampai seminit. Okay, so you can immediately do that. That's not require a lot of setting up. Yang lain tu, it has its own tools. It has have its own pro and cons. It have its own features yang menarik. So you have that as well. Mentimeter ni pun ada juga leaderboard, tapi boring lah leaderboard dia. Macam tak ada apa, macam gitu je lah. Compared dengan leaderboard yang you kita gunakan dalam let's say quizzes for example. Quizzes, dia ada music, jadi macam excited sikit lah. Kalau Mentimeter ni boring gila. Music yang dia ada tu pun syahdu je. Okay, so.
Yeah, I think purpose lah kan. Sometimes to look professional, terlalu lively sangat pun tak sesuai. Purpose tu penting.
Betul, kalau macam let's say you nak buat sebagai energizer, maybe quizzes will be something much more interesting. So depends lah, you know, kalau let's say you ada class the whole day contohnya, maybe you nak pelbagaikan, you want to okay to wrap up, you gunakan quizzes contohnya, at the end to just want to do okay just to check how the knowledge wise. Maybe quizzes is interesting because of dia ada macam element of competition. People need to be fast and whatnot. But we also have people who have difficulties to log in because of internet stability and whatnot. So Mentimeter, it has its own reason why you use Mentimeter as well. Kalau takkan you nak dapat feedback ataupun you wanted to have a quick assessment, so a quick response kita panggil, so Mentimeter might be one of those that you can opt to, let's say at the beginning ataupun as let's say in between of the classes. So you kata alright, so let's recap on what we have done so far, one point lesson contohnya. So you can use the cloud and then ataupun cloud ataupun the other one too where they can type what they have learned, you do that as well. I guna untuk majority of the time I guna as an icebreaker, so to get where to just understand. Sometimes I guna untuk what do you want to learn today, you know, for this program. So as an icebreaker or just to get to understand where they are. And then kalau contohnya I buat katalah Mentimeter, I just want to know how many people have used Mentimeter before, so I can use Mentimeter and launch that. And say, okay, how many of you have used Mentimeter before? Kita adalah rating dia tu kan, yes, no, or never heard before. So you can tick and then you can see the bar. Just now macam ada buat tadi yang makan, favorite makan tu. And then kalau kata let's say after the class tu, you rasa you just nak check the temperature where they are at this point. So maybe you just ask them some question. Ataupun you just, before you end the first session, ataupun recap the next day tu, I can use in the morning. I can ask, okay, what was a one point lesson from yesterday class? So then you can have that as well as a recap.
Right.
Okay, so there's a lot of, it depends on how you want to use it. Everything other is up to your creativity sahaja.
Terbaik lah.
All right. Okay.
Tengok, dah pukul 10 lebih. Sekejap je. Ceng, dah habis sejam. Itulah. Lepas tu bila orang kata, oh sejam lamanya, I said no, not using full time. Aku just maybe not using full time, sejam ni bagi kami tu macam macam baru start je, baru intro pun dah sejam.
That is itulah. Okay, so ada soalan lain yang ada lagi yang kita boleh bertanya, yang boleh kita boleh jawab, macam Mentimeter ni.
Maksudnya dah kot, sekat ni.
Alright, let's go.
Kan tak ada tidur malam.
Alright.
It has been great and sharing by Fina. Rasanya lepas ni ramai orang boleh start exploring.
Boleh.
Apa ni Mentimeter ni, and try to find a way yang you punya trademark. Macam mana nak gunakan Mentimeter ni dalam you punya online session, meetings ke whatever. You know, itu yang kita nak cuba tengok. Oh, ramai.